Hello everyone. Hello. Welcome to Art Thrill Studio. And this is Anuja. Anybody can type a yes if you can hear me and you can see me. So just checking the audio and the video once. Anybody just type a yes and then we will start. Okay, thank you. Hello everyone. Yes, today we are going to start a new art form and that is Kalamkari. Now Kalamkari is a very, very famous art. Many of you must have seen it. Good afternoon everyone, good afternoon. Good to see you after a long time. Okay, first of all, I want to thank each one of you and the others also who subscribed me, and the channel went across 5,000 subscribers. So my hearty thanks to each one of you. So hear it 5,000 times. So it is each one of you. Personally, I thank you all. So your all love and support has proved good and this channel is doing so well. I'm so happy about it. And good that we are learning and we are sharing the art forms that are there. Today we are going to talk about Kalamkari, and Kalamkari is the art. It's not a folk art. It's not a tribal art. It's a folk art. So there are majorly three types of art. One is the tribal, then it is the folk art, and then it is the fine art. So folk art is something that is practiced and done by the people of that area, and it's very popular in that area, and slowly these folk arts have become very, very popular, and Indian crafts and art forms are being given a very good platform in the globally also. Hello, very good. Okay, so today coming back to our Kalamkari session, what we will be needing, I will be going through that as well. First, I will tell you about what is Kalamkari. So Kalamkari is an art that has a literal translation from Kalamkari. That is, Kalam is the pen and Kari is the art. So Kalamkari is the art made by the pen. Now Kalamkari has two major forms, two major styles. One is Kalahasti and the other is Machalipatnam. Now these two forms, I will just show you the difference between these two forms. Machalipatnam is majorly not the pen style. Pen workmanship is not there. It is done by the block. So the block printing is done, but the style remains the same. So a lot of blocks are created for one motif and they do the stenciling of it. So block printing. Whereas in Sri Kalahasti, these were wanderers, and these wanderers wandered all over the villages singing and doing craftsmanship and illustrating the whatever they are narrating. So from the Hindu mythology, from Ramayana, Mahabharata, gods, they were making those, and they were also making beautiful motifs from whatever the scene was there. So this was their art form. This was more of a freehand art style. So I will put this down here while I will take you to the course. This will be a course. And yes, Prabha, yes, if you have any doubt, please ask. So with this course, we will start with basic. What are the basic shapes, borders, and what motifs? What is the difference between Machalipatnam and the art form, which is Sri Kalahasti style, Kalahasti style basically. And then we will do idols, how to make the face, side profile, front face, and how to do different motifs. Different borders and different types of plants and flowers will be our topic. For sheets, we have A3 size paper. Okay, I will clear all your doubts on the supplies. I will show you on my desk. So here, I am just taking an A4 size paper. I said 3 4 papers. If you just keep it handy, it's always good. If you need to practice, just keep 3 4 papers. So this is a paper which is A4 size. If I see, it is the cartridge paper, and anything which will be a little like 140 GSM will be a good size of a good thickness. So 140 grams per square meter is a good paper. You can work on this because it is not done basically with our micron pens or anything. It is done by the traditional pen, so ink is involved. And so I generally take 140 GSM. So if you have 140 GSM, cool. If you do not have 140 GSM, if you have any other printing paper, you can learn the art, and whenever you want to make a bigger size painting, you can go for that. Oh, thank you, and that's the oil painting that you are seeing at the back. Okay. Yeah, I love oil paints, and I do a lot of oil paints also. Okay. So this today I will be working with my waterproof drawing ink and my pen. Now, this is not actually the pen that was used by the people. So the pen I will all we will talk so that you get to know the art form. The pen that was made by the bamboo sticks. So these bamboo sticks were collected. So this is a bamboo stick here, and the kalam was prepared. So you will see that it doesn't have a very fine tip over here. It is blunt. And whereas few of the nib pens, when we create the bamboo nibs, we sharpen it very fine. So this is the work that I do with authentically. When I do it like in a traditional way, I use the traditional bamboo pens. So this is a very pointed one. And generally, those kalam, which are different tip sizes, are involved, and we just sharpen it. How the kalam is made in the Kalamkari is we take cotton. You don't have to make it. I'll just show you how it is so that you get the idea of how it is made. So some cotton cloth or cotton is involved in this, and where we hold the pen. So where the pen is, where we grip the pen, that is the place where this cotton is kept like this. And then a thread is used to tie this along. I'm taking this cotton thread, and we have to tie in a way like we put it in the spool. So it's a crisscross method like this. And this is how we do this. This is a demo that I'm showing you about how the pen is made. So it's really interesting, and you can have a look at it, and then we will start with our regular pen that we have. Now, how much ever you want this. And why is this done is because the colors, we soak it in color. This cotton will absorb all the color, and while we are holding it and we press it gently, the color glides down through the stick, and then we can go and work for a longer time. So this is how this pen is made. So just winding it around in a crisscross manner. So we have this puffy thing, but it is not coming off loose. I'll just cut it off. So once you dip this in any of the color, any paint, this absorbs a lot of color. And while you are drawing something or filling it, you will be holding it from here, and you squeeze it, gently squeeze it, and then you can work endlessly with this. So this is a kind of, I'm just a small demo of how the kalam is made in Kalamkari. So this is the form of it. But we'll not be doing it with this. Here instead, I'm using a drawing nib and a metal tip and the drawing ink. So any question that anybody has, you can write it down, then we will start. Can we use gel pen or sketch pen? You may use anything to do, because today we are doing the borders. I will be telling you the basics of it, how to start with. Once we are doing the final, when we know that okay, we are good with the final thing, we will start with that. So here, I'm just giving my ink a little shake to get it. Typically, this is not done on paper actually. Yes, you may use a printing paper also, any paper to begin with for today. Typically, it was done on the cotton fabric. Now, there is a big treatment that goes along with the cotton fabric. There are two styles, Machilipatnam and Srikalahasti. I'll show you a fabric which is Machilipatnam. Machilipatnam is very finely crafted, this block, and then that block is dipped in ink and it has been stenciled. So you will see that all the faces here are stenciled the same way. So it is block printing on the cloth. This is the Machilipatnam style. It is no way less, or if we say that, oh, this is just a block printing, no, it involves a lot of intricate work as well. Lot of craftsmanship in giving these details from in on a wooden block. First, that is done. There is a lot of karigari involved in that also. Once this was laid out, and then it was blocked. Once the block is done, after that, many multiple blocks are used. This is a single block piece because here there is no color involved. But if in case we use colors, then we will have to make different blocks for different colors. So templates, those blocks will be made, and one design would have multiple wooden blocks involved. So depending on how much the in a block also, how many colors, how intricate the work is, and how many colors are involved, the price also goes high. So this is the Machilipatnam style, and the Sri Kalahasti. Now, these wanderers, people were used to wander from place to place. They used to sing and they used to narrate the things, and they used to do freehand. There was no tracing, nothing done. So it was just a freehand thing. It's a very elaborate process. First, the cloth is put into washing. Once it is all free from starch, the same cloth is soaked in goat or buffalo milk, soaked for some time. Then it is squeezed with special seeds which give the brown color. So once that brown color is obtained, it is put to dry. Once that dries, then these organic colors and alums and different seeds, the color is extracted. And yeah, I'll answer the question for a while. Okay, Parvati, just excuse others. Parvati has a question and answer. Ma'am, can we use a black gel pen? Yes. Okay, so coming back to the pen, and these we will start and we will talk all together. So first I will go on my table and we will start making few basic shapes that are involved in this drawing. So you may take a black gel pen, that is totally fine. I am using it with the nib and the ink. So the borders are of different thickness. It can be thin or thick as per the desire. So I dip it, and here I am making of different thickness. We'll start with a thin border. Here, this is the line. There is a very common shape of a flower, and it is like this, and we cover it. I'll just zoom in a little there and here. So we go like this. We will see that the outer line will be curved mostly. It will have these kind of shape. This is the border, and here it may or may not have colors. And then here, this is a folk art, and you don't have to be very specific about how many curves are there, somewhat it has to be the similar, but you will not see any perfection. And this is a freehand thing, and you may not just want to count the petals or anything. So just go in a circular manner, in a shape of a flower, and then just connect it with this. So generally we see that the motifs and the borders, there's a lot of flowers, birds, different motifs of elephants, horses, and other things. Size of the nib. It is the same drawing nib that I use for all the other things. There is no size, it's a drawing nib. So drawing nib will have a point, and there is no size. Calligraphy nibs will have sizes. It is size, otherwise it's my drawing nib for Tatikawa, size 3. A5, yes, you may use any paper. It is just the borders. Now, depending on whether the border is thick or thin, depends. If you want to make the bigger painting, just keep the border thin. If you want the jal or the motif or a nature inspired thing, you can make bigger flowers also. Yes, size 3 is the nib size. G nib. Now, this is the border one. We will see mostly flowers and leaves. Next, this is a very simple, the simplest flower, and now we are going to do a leaf pattern. This is a wavy thing here, giving a double line. That is the thickness of the stem. And dip pens and the drawing nibs are same, they are slightly different. Dip pen can be any pen that you dip and do your work. There are glass pen also, they are dip pens. Glass pens and the calligraphy pens, they are all the dip pens. So just going with the leaf pattern here, you will see that the line is a little curved. Can't see the video. Okay, let me check. Okay, let me check for a minute. Please wait, let me check what's going wrong. I hope you all can see now. Now, doing the leaves, we'll go with the leaf shape. But the outer of the leaf will be a little rounded. like that. I hope the screen is back, I guess. Yeah. You may or may not have the same kind of leaf. It can be small, big, different shapes, it's okay. This is a general form of leaf that is there. When it goes freehand, it is not stenciled or it is not traced. Wherever the space goes, like the trees are growing organically, in the same way the design also grows organically. So this is the second one. Now there is no double lining also in this. It is a single line. This is a very basic flower and this is a very basic leaf. Now we have one beautiful pattern that is very vastly seen and particularly only in this Srikalahasti style of, we make this S kind of a shape. And then we continue doing the same on the other side. And this is how the chain is built up. This is a very beautiful style. You will see that the curves will go a little in, so be particular about that. This will give a very beautiful shape. Now here, now from this we will go here and we will connect this here. So this is a kind of shape that is seen mostly in it. It looks twisted. Now there are variations in this one. Okay, Meg, even I was missing, I was just caught up with few things which I couldn't ignore. So I'm so sorry about that. Even I was. Okay, so this one, now we will do the fourth one with the small variation in the same. This style is alternately placed. This small design is alternately placed and it looks very beautiful. I'll just show you. Like this. So in this we get a little scope of coloring it also. If we happen to do the coloring, it gets a little brightened and gives a very good look. So this can be changed. Now we'll go to the fifth one. So these are the four we have done so far. There is one more small thing that can be added in the first one, in the second one, there is this kind of a shape. Wherever we want to make the design a little heavy or more full, we can add those design. Fifth design. Hello, Jyotsna. Hello, Kavita. So here, now we are going to make the same the thing that we made here, the twirl. Just doing the twirl over here. Putting it down. So the first turn goes like this. Put it down. Here in this picture or Kalamkari style of artwork, you will not see a lot of geometric, or rather nothing is geometrical here. It's all freehand and more of the curvier style are being followed. So it was done by the wanderers. They were called Chitrakatis. And they used to illustrate it on the cloth. They used to paint it, and these were hung on the temple walls. The cloth was hung on the temple walls. So just connecting all of this, it looks very beautiful. This is also one style. Now this is the kind of borders that you will see. No matter what is being done, we just make a little line, which is like this. So this is a very famous trait of Kalamkari. Now, a very, very famous and very commonly seen is this kind of a shape. You can also put this shape in the border, or you can also put this shape around the motif. The bordering of the motif, we use this. We will do this when we will do our motifs on elephants, horses, and peacocks, parrots. Then we will be using this immensely. Thank you, Kavita. It's my pleasure. I'm so thankful to all of you, giving so much of love and always ready to learn. So, it's not very important for us whether there are two humps or three humps. Whatever style suits you, you may continue doing that. If you want it higher, like more dense, 3-4, you can do that. Later, this portion can be filled with any color. That is how we get the whole thing into colors. If you have not subscribed the channel, press the subscribe button. That's the request. It is from Andhra. It is from Andhra Pradesh. Kalamkari is from Andhra Pradesh, and this style that we are doing is the Chitrakala Hasti style. It's the Sri Kala Hasti. That is a small temple in Chittur district of this Andhra, and it's very close to the river. So this temple, till date also there are people who stay there, these Chitrakatis, they stay there and they are still serving the temple. So Kalahasti is the style and Sri Kalahasti is the temple, that small temple that is there. Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad you all are liking it. So these are the small borders. Generally the border is we use one or two thin stripes of border also. We can use it sometimes. We can use the broad. We will do few of the broad and the more floral ones too, right? Now the seventh. We may also do the flowers, different flowers, different types of flowers, whatever is common, you can put it inside and make the veils of it. I'm generally doing it with a black color. Different colors are used, but these colors are typically organic colors and not synthetic colors. This shape of the leaf, if in case it is very hard for few of you to draw, I'll just give you the idea of how it is. If in case it is difficult. So here we have a leaf shaped like this. Generally, this is easy. But what is the difference between this and that is only that. Just visualize the same shape, but give it a curvier edge. So that is the only shape. Now, if we happen to see a leaf that is round, then again, how do we convert it into this? We will just do it like so the shapes are almost the same as we see, but this curvier edge, this edge is a little the typical thing that is there. Do we have to keep dipping the pen in ink regularly? Yes, one time you dip the pen, after you go for a while, it will be out of ink. Then you have to re-dip your pen. And then after few dips and drying, once it dries, you dip it again, you dip it again. Couple of times this will happen, then you'll have to wipe it off nicely so that there is no buildup of the ink. So this way, acrylic paint, yes, if you are doing it on the cloth, definitely we do not have all the organic colors, or we have the availability, or we are not very skilled to extract those colors, then definitely if you want to do it on the cloth, you will go with the fabric paint. If you want to do it on the paper, you can use acrylic. So those who want to do it and do not have this ink, you can make this ink with your acrylic paints also. I have shared a video when I was doing the Madhubani. I have shared a video where you can actually make your own ink in different colors using the acrylic paints. There is a consistency check that you have to do, how much water you have to add and how you will be able to make your own ink. And anyway, when your acrylic paint dries, it is permanent. So if you make the drawing ink with your acrylic paint, then it will be very stable. So here, after doing this much as you asked, then I have built up on my nib here. And then I will just wipe it off with, and it is detachable. This is detachable, and I've taken it out. Even after wiping, there's so much of residue that is there. It's dried, right? Can you see? Okay. So I will just clean it and reinsert it in my holder. be gentle while you clean it, because you might not want to, you will definitely not want to disturb the tip. Then again, insert it and you are good to go for further use. So I have dipped. If those who have a query on how often I dipped it now, and next time when I'll dip, I'll let you know. So this is the 8th one that I'm doing. This time a little broader one. A mix of flour and leaves. I have to dip it again now. This, now I'm just doing these few. Like so. This is a little bigger flower. Like this, doing it on the alternate sides. The beauty of this art is if it is done by hand, if it's done, it's handmade, you will always see that there is some bleeding of the color, there's some overlap in the color, and some people who do not who are not aware of the literally how it is done might feel that it's not very neat, but that is the traditional way of doing. Oh good, Mausumi, if you wanted to learn, and here it is now. Drawing inks are waterproof. Until and if your ink is waterproof, you can use it. It can be any brand, it is okay. It may be of any brand, that is fine. It has to be drawing inks. This is a waterproof ink. So even if I will put some color on it, maybe if you want to put colors later, then the black of the outline will not come inside the color and just turn the color black. So that is why whatever lines you are making, it is important that it should be with waterproof. Here this. Just small flowers over here, and then it can be big or small, whatever you want to do. So a smaller one, if you want to do a bigger one, you can do a bigger one. The leaf stays the same. There are different styles of leaves also. We will be doing it in the free page, out of the border. Like this. I like the 8th one. Yes, slowly we are going on to the difficult ones. Now there is one more. Once you are done with this one, the how do you connect the borders? That is, it will never come with the like straight lines and bands. Then what happens is, just doing this scallop design. Then if I want to add the valance here or the flowers hanging, how do I do it? If I want to do the leaves, how do I do it? We'll do a continuous borders now. So it's just a mango shape or the parsley shape. That is also very common. Where do we get bamboo pens? Traditionally, it is just you'll have to go around and look for a bamboo piece, and that's how I make my own bamboo pen. Otherwise, there are a few art stores which will sell you the bamboo pens, and I have few from the store. These are machine-made bamboo pens, and they are like this. So you get it in the art store, depending where you, if you are lucky, you'll get it. But I feel I have worked with this pen also, and I have worked with the real bamboo stick also, and I feel real bamboo stick works good. These machine, they are pressed so fine that the absorbency of the tip is lost. It's very hard. So I really doubt whether it's bamboo or it's some special fiber that has been created. I don't know. It's too much of a artificially done thing on a natural stuff. So I would prefer. I have worked with these pens and they work nice. I shave it off, I sharpen it to get the desired point, and then I work, and they work really good. So these are good ones. So if you are If you may make one, always try. Oh, great. Your uncle gave you one. Yes, you may use nib pens. If in case you do not have these nibs, then you can go for micron or drawing pens. Any of the ones which has permanent ink. So here, this one. Now, after this, again, how to edge this is giving this kind of an edge. You may not want to be very, very specific about it. Like in Madhubani, we do it very calculatively, very nicely. You may just go a little loose on this. And now I will just hang a few violins. How do we put the flowers when we make the paintings of the gods? How do we do that? Just adding these. This is a kind of a border, generally on the top. Like this. So this is when we are making some god or anything or idol or anything which is from the mythology. We would just put a border with some toran or anything, and then these are all symbols, and then this is a valance or whatever decorations are hung. So this is. Yes, exactly. It's like a toran. And you can just repeat it for two, three times, giving some space so that. And again, one more. So this way. Thank you, Parolia. Okay, this painting, for those who missed, it is I discussed about all the origin and the history of it, and it is done from the it is from Andhra Pradesh, and it is Kalamkari. So I should actually write it here. So this is Kalamkari. And now we'll do a few motifs of the flowers. Some elaborate leaf. Sometimes you will see without any edge, but authentically it comes to the edgy part. There is one more, which is this shape. So depending on the place and the space, they will just grow organically. So it is not really very calculated, but this forms a very nice edge and it can be used as a border. We'll do a few types of border, a few flowers which can be used as a jal or they can be used inside the border as well. So a few flowers. So this is the core of the flower. This is a very simple, we often make it in our regular drawing also. And we can have the connecting flower on the other side. The stem bifurcation is shown in a different manner. Sometimes a flower grows in the middle of this. So we'll just do a jal pattern. It grows organically and there is no set pattern that okay, this leaf is next to the flower. So in the next also it will be following the same place. Jal is the overall cover of the motif. So if I happen to say it's the overall design. So the fabric which have the flower print all over, but they are all drawn freehand. It is not a block. If sometimes we see the fabric is overall blocked, like the stencils are very big, Just like we have the stencils for the wall painting, we do the same, we cover the whole wall like that. But in the fabric also this happens. Overall it will be bigger stencils or the blocks will be used, and it looks that it is not connecting, but you will see the same repeat of the same block after a certain area. Thank you, Rupa, thanks a lot. Okay, so this is here the bifurcation. And I may do a side view of this flower. How to do the side view of the flower? The side petals. This, yeah, I can extend this as well, going a little down this side and following it in like this. So this can grow in a different manner. Filling up spaces will only determine how dense you have placed your picture, your design, or how scanty the design is. Thank you for your subscription. Thank you. Like this. So this is how we come from our easy designs to how we go on our bigger designs. Now we'll just go on a different kind of a flower here. I'll take a bigger place to show you a bigger one. So here the core, you will see that the core will be there. Generally, there will be side leaves. This is or has some similarities from the Persian art as well. So a lot of influence, not influence I would say, but similarity. Just like we have our Gond art is very similar to the Aboriginal art of Australia. The same way, the Persian art is also similar to this, very much similar. For those who have to miss the class, or those who will miss a section of the workshop, you may watch the video recording. It will be posted on the channel. So if in case you miss it now, it will be available after some time. So this. Another border, I'll just show you which border. So another border just to cover this. Sometimes with all these floral and curvy borders, we do get some geometric, and we won't say just geometric, but they are very repetitive. So suppose this is a flower over here, then half a flower over here, then half a flower over here. Just the valence we did, we are just repeatedly doing this form. So This kind of design is mostly used for garlands, when we are doing gourds, for decorations. I'll just give you a run through of what we will, just an introduction to the whole course, what we will be doing. So stay connected, do not miss sessions, and you can also invite others. Probably many of others won't know. This is the Kalamkari course, and starting from the borders, we will do the mudras. Now, mudras are the postures that they do it with the hands. The mudra, there's a symbolic mudras, how the hands will be there. We will do the faces, front face, side face, man, woman, particular color code for different type of people. For ladies, what color is used, for men, for demons, for so there is a whole study on that. We will be talking about that as well, and we will also talk about we will be drawing a lot of motifs as well. Motifs will include the peacocks, parrots, beautifully heavily adorned or beautified horses and elephants. There are many different kinds of birds and animals, along with the gods, bulls. So Krishna, Ganesha, Saraswati, these from the Hindu mythology. So we will be drawing few of them. So those who are connected to me on the WhatsApp group, good enough. Otherwise, please connect to me on my Facebook page. Always, you will get a notification or whatever is upcoming from there. Now here there is another kind of a leaf. Long. This longer leaf. This leaf can also have a small tone. You may stick to one style. I wanted to tell you, ma'am, please teach on cloth. Okay, sure. First, we have to, because I cannot teach you all the borders on one cloth. Whenever we'll do a final picture, we'll choose to do it on the cloth. I'll consider it. Now there is a this kind of a shape. Like this. So this shows the side of it. A small variation can bring a lot of change, so depends on what style do you want to choose. So this is what we have done today. Few of the borders, majorly you will see two or three borders which are very very common. This number three is one of them. Number three and four you will see majorly. Five, six, these above are very commonly used, these top ones, because they are thin borders and they can be used vastly in in every artwork. Some of the paintings may not have the borders. They will just have few two or three triple lines, and that's it. And they will just fill up the center, the main thing. So it is not very important, but definitely a beautiful border enhances the picture a lot. Any doubts or any questions that anybody has, you may write it down now, and then I can just answer all of it. Anybody has any question, please, you can raise it. We can also make it colored, and for coloring here in the class, we will be using acrylic paints. You may also use poster color if you want to do it, if you get it framed. If you are using it on the cloth, then you may use the acrylic or the fabric paints. Okay, so if you have any queries or any doubts, write it in the comment box and I will get back. I'll try to answer all your questions and doubts that you may have. How will we do tomorrow? We will do some mudras and the faces tomorrow. So here, okay, you want a full view of it? There it is. So it is just basic capsulated form of the borders. When we will be doing different, we will be doing different borders in each, so that there is a difference in each of the paintings, and we will learn more. Okay, thank you everyone for taking out time here, and hope to see you tomorrow at 3. If in case you've missed a certain part of the video, then you can access it later. It will be put up on the YouTube channel, and probably it will stay there for a long time. Yes, Prabha. Yes, you can ask your question. What doubt? Thank you, Hina. Okay, so I will be ending the meet, and I will be still available for some time to answer your chats. Okay, so bye-bye, everyone. Take care, and see you tomorrow.